Hi, I'm Jason Bowdach for PixelTools, and welcome to this quick start tutorial on installing Film Emulsion. I will guide you step by step on how to install this product and how to get started using it. So, the first step is to launch DaVinci Resolve and navigate to the LUT folder. If you're not familiar how to do that, you do that by going to the project settings, going to the color management, and clicking open LUT folder. See that it's opened my LUT folder right here. Now I'm actually going to hide DaVinci Resolve, and you'll see right here that I have the extracted zip that is the exact same thing that you downloaded from our website after purchase. Now, what we want to do is go to the DCTL and LUT install file within. You'll notice that there are two different versions within this folder. One called No Icon, used with control panels, and one simply labeled Mac, Windows, and Linux. The difference between these two are one has icons and one has no icons. The icon version is for people that want to use a mouse and keyboard, and the no icon version is for those using a mini or advanced Blackmagic control surface. The icon version is not compatible with Blackmagic control surfaces. So, depending on your specific setup, you can install either the icon version or the no icon version. Because I'm currently using a Blackmagic mini control surface, I'm going to proceed with installing the no icon version, but the install process is exactly the same. So within these folders, you'll see that we have a PixelTools folder. All you need to do to install this is copy this folder and paste it within your LUT folder. If you already have a PixelTools product installed, all you have to do is overwrite and everything should be copied into your existing PixelTools folder. I'm going to copy this and paste it into my LUT folder. So the install is now complete. Really, really important, you must restart DaVinci Resolve after installing any DCTL for it to be recognized, or you will get errors. So I'm going to quit DaVinci Resolve and we'll relaunch it in 1 second. First, I want to dive into this folder and we'll take a look at what we're installing really quick. So we have a PixelTools placeholder, which is useful for separating PixelTools DCTLs from any other DCTLs you might have installed. We have two different custom DCTLs, PixelTools Film Emulsion Neg and PixelTools Film Emulsion Print, one for the negative and one for the print. We also have a folder within called Film Emulsion LUTs. So in here, we have a variety of the lookup tables that we're using for these print stocks and negative stocks. It is very, very important that you do not move or rename this folder or the LUTs within. If you do, you will get an error when you try and use the DCTLs. If you want to use these in another application or anywhere else, feel free to make another copy of them, but it's incredibly important that you leave this entire PixelTools folder exactly as is for the DCTLs to function properly. So, let's relaunch Resolve, and I'll show you how you can apply this. So I'm relaunching Resolve. It's now going to detect the new DCTLs, and we can start working with them. I'm going to open up that exact same project. And before I jump in, I'm going to install the PowerGrades that also come with the tools. So I'm going to navigate back. We don't need the LUT folder anymore, so I can close that. And I'm going to go to the additional BIOS folder that's in the zip file as well. So you'll see the PowerGrade DRX files folder within. And you'll see that there are two different DRX files included. So there is a no icons version if you install the no icon versions like I just did, and an icons version for those that install the regular version. I'm going to proceed to just drag this no icon version into my stills folder if I want it just for this project, or if I want it to be for the entire database, you can actually install it as a power grade. So the difference between a power grade and a still is that the still is only available in this single project, whereas the power grade works with the entire database. So you can start a brand new project and you will find this power grade there. You can see that I already created a new power grade album and named it Film Emulation essentially. And I'm just going to drag my DRX file right in there. So to apply this, I'm going to right click and apply grade. So you see, I already have a setup. Now, before I go through the setup real quickly, I want to show you some settings that are really important in the project settings. Let's go over to color management, and you'll see that my color space transforms are not set up correctly. all of the LUTs and film stocks have been profiled for DaVinci Wide Gamut. We will be adding additional color management systems at a later date, but for right now, they are all expecting DaVinci Wide Gamut. So what I want to do is set the timeline color space to DaVinci Wide Gamut, and the output color space should be matching your monitor. In my case, I'm working with Rec. 709 Gamma 2.4, so I'm going to set that right here. Also, if you haven't adjusted your 3D lookup table interpolation from trilinear to tetrahedral, you can go ahead and do that right now. Let's save. And we can start working with this. Now, right here, this is our input, and I have a CST setup. This is actually an RE clip, so I need to change this to match your camera. In this case, I'm working with RE Log C3, so I'm going to change that. And this is where you'll set your camera. Whatever your specific camera is, you would set the input color space and input gamut right here. Last but not least, I have my output settings going from DaVinci Wide Gamut to Rec. 709 Gamut 2.4. If you want to change this to HDR, you would change the output color space and gamma accordingly to specifically what spec you're going for. Now, in between this is where our entire film pipeline is happening. We start with our negative. Let's go into a larger view. Our film emulsion neg, DCTL applied. And we start with negative intensity. We also have some exposure, temperature, tint, contrast, and pivot controls for you. And here is where you can select your negative stock. Now I have a Vision 3 500T5219 stock, which is one of my favorites, but you can also go through a Vision 2, one of the older Vision 1 stocks, all the way to something like a Kodak Aero color. So this is for you to experiment with. There is no such thing as the right stock. This is for you to have fun with and experiment on your projects. Now, I'm going to go down the pipeline a little bit. We have a halation effect that is powered by the built-in film look creator. We will be replacing this at a later date with our own custom tools, but for right now, we're using the built-in resolve effects. Next, we have our highlight roll-off, which we are currently using a curve to do that. Next, we have a sharpen node. Next, we have grain. And if I dive into this compound node, you see that we have a little bit of a blurring happening, followed by two different grain nodes depending on the resolution of your output. If you're using HD, you can use this node. If you're using 4K, you can use this node. Currently, we're using the built-in Resolve film grain, but eventually we will be switching this out with our own custom DCTL for film grain at a future date. Next, we have some gate weave, and last but not least, we have our print. So our print is powered by our PixelTools Film Emulation Print DCTL, and we have a couple of additional controls here from print intensity, contrast and pivot, and subtractive saturation. So you have your choices of three different print stocks, the Kodak 2383, the Kodak 2393, and the Fuji 3510, which happens to be my favorite. Now, currently, like I mentioned, we are only supporting the DaVinci Wide Gamut or DaVinci Intermediate transfer function, but we will be adding additional ones at a future date. And then last but not least, we have our ODT, or as this note is calling it, output. Now, for the built-in power grade, I am just using a CST to go from DaVinci Wide Gamut Intermediate to Rec. 709 Gamma 2.4. But you can swap this out for whatever DRT you prefer, whether it be JP2499 or OpenDRT. We've tested this and confirmed that it works with all of those, and it was designed to work with your choice of DRT. We are simply including the CST just for convenience built into the power grade. We are really proud of the team behind this, and we will be continuing to improve this product over the next year or two. So your feedback and suggestions would be greatly appreciated. If there is something that you're not quite happy with or something that you would like to see improve, we would love to hear from you. And you can reach us at info@pixeltoolspost.com, and we will be reading and keeping track of the comments. Hope you enjoy, and happy grading.